The Dow sold off yesterday. It dropped more than 200 points. It marked the second largest point decline of 2013. So what is going on? Peter Schiff joins us now to talk about it. He's with Euro Pacific Capital. Peter, what happened? Why did the Dow sell off yesterday?
Well, maybe the better question is, why has it been rallying all these days or weeks or months? And I think Wall Street has been trying to convince itself that despite the data, that the U.S. economy is actually recovering. And I think over the last several weeks, so many data points have come in to disappoint this fantasy of an economic recovery that maybe is finally starting to set in. And I think maybe some people on Wall Street are paying attention to the minutes from the Federal Reserve Advisory Board, which basically confirmed everything I've been saying for years, which is that the recovery is not real. It's simply an asset bubble created by the Fed, and that when the cheap money goes away, so will the recovery. Asset prices will fall, and consumers and businesses are in for a lot of pain when the Fed stops the stimulus.
Peter, let me touch on a couple of things. Okay, so you talked about when the cheap money goes away, there's going to be a problem. But on a day where, if the markets had ended in the green yesterday, with weak data that you're talking about, you could have expected people to say that the markets rose because people were more confident that that cheap money was going to continue, and so were optimistic the Fed wasn't going to pull out, and so that's why the market rallied. So can't you kind of make it a choose-your-own-adventure with the markets?
Well, I think, though, much of the rally is based on the false narrative of an improving economy that's going to improve corporate earnings. That's pure fantasy. And I think if you look at what's happening in Japan, that might be scaring some people, because the Japanese now, with all their money printing, interest rates are rising, and interest rates are rising here too. And maybe some of the traders are starting to figure out that just because the Fed prints money and buys bonds, it doesn't mean interest rates on long-term bonds are going to go down. In fact, they could end up going a lot higher. So maybe it's the fear of rising interest rates in a weakening environment that's undermining the market. And even if the Fed is printing money, it's not going to overcome that. What investors should be looking at, though, I think, is gold and other commodities that have been weak. I don't think the gold traders are waking up to what's going on. And if you look at the dollar is starting to roll over, but I think it should be a lot lower given all the fundamentals that have come out, all the bad news that has come out that has surprised so many people.
But what are you referring to when you say all the bad news and the false recovery? Because for every negative data point, there's positive data points. I mean, we get a bad ADP report, but then we get the Fed Beige Book saying there's modest growth, the housing recovery is fueling modest growth and manufacturing.
That's not real data. That's just them talking. I mean, they want to talk up the economy. Mm-hmm. The only supposed evidence of the recovery is the fact that house prices are up or stock prices are up or that people are more confident. But that's not real. Stock prices are up because of the cheap money. People are confident because they think they're richer or because they believe the hype in the media that there's a recovery, even though they're not experiencing it. But if you look at the actual data that's coming out on the economy, you know, the ISM, manufacturing, all that stuff, the jobs data, the real hard numbers, not just the talk. All those data points are consistently negative.
But I thought you don't believe the hard numbers, Peter, that come out from the government.
Well, a lot of those numbers aren't necessarily all government sourced. A lot of them are coming from the private sector. But yeah, I don't believe the government propaganda when it comes to things like inflation.